Welcome back. A Happy Mum, Happy Child Facebook page has recently cracked over 50,000. A very warm welcome to much-loved parenting blogger Maria Foy. Now, you were just on the coffee group. You talked about life changing when you had kids. What was life like before you had kids?
Well, I worked full-time in an office, so it was a really... not a boring job, it was quite interesting, but it certainly wasn't parenting.
Yeah, and I'm sure also it would have been a lot cleaner.
Yes, definitely. A lot more organised.
A lot cleaner. So tell us a little bit about your blog.
Well, it started out, Happy Mum, Happy Child, started out as a website to document the activities that I did for my kids. And it kind of just grew from there and is now this little wee hub or community of parents that come together to keep it real, to know that it's okay to have down days and parenting, it's not easy. So.
It's not easy, but it's a whole heap of fun as well. Let's take a look at one of these clips.
Do you want to come and play?
Yeah, I do want to come and play. Guys, I'm just going to the toilet. Guys, I'm going to the toilet.
Okay.
That's just two of many. And you know what makes it so funny is that that has been me in my life before. And the thing is that you don't, this sounds terrible, but sometimes playing with children can be really boring.
It is hard. I find it really hard just to pretend to be something I'm not. I think that's just because I'm an adult. I can't get down to that kid level.
Superhero games where you have to be the superhero for hours on end.
And listening to you two talk, I guess that's what helped the blog evolve, because
Absolutely.
It's actually expressing how you feel and letting everybody else know and them all going, that's how I feel as well.
Yeah,
is that kind of how it got started?
Absolutely. I talk a lot about my postnatal depression, and that brought a whole lot of people in because they suddenly realised that it's okay to talk about it. And then I started talking about parenting a whole lot more. And like you said, Mike, it just sort of opens everybody up. And phew, I'm not the worst person in the world to not want to play with my kids all the time.
Well, exactly. I think every single parent has, at one stage or another, locked themselves in the toilet. without a bag of chips.
Yeah. Or chocolate, yeah.
So why do you think it's been so successful? Because you've reached that sort of level of, this is normal, this is what it's actually like?
I think so. I mean, a lot of it's luck and timing and all of that jazz, but I do think there's something about just being open and honest about parenting, and I try and keep it as real as possible. Obviously, I don't put everything out there, but I do as much as I can. So, and try and make it a little bit funny, because you got to have a laugh.
And I guess technology's helped with this discussion a lot, because what do you think parents were doing before we had the internet, before we had the blogs?
I always think about that. I think they used to read books or
magazines.
Right.
Yeah, read magazines and we'd read books. That's exactly what we do back in the days.
And where do you think you want to take this? You know, obviously it's going great, but where do you want it to evolve to?
I just want it to keep growing the community, and especially in New Zealand. I'd love to obviously go a little bit more worldwide, and so that everybody else in the world knows it's okay, although there are a lot of other sites out there for that.
And then we'll see you on Ellen as well.
Yeah.
How do you deal with the trolls, the people that I saw somebody had posted about what you feed your children, that everyone's got an opinion on what you do online, and some of them are not very inspired, shall we say. So how do you deal with the people that troll you?
I try and, when I'm on a good day and I've got my barrier up, I try and just remember that everyone's entitled to their own opinion, and that as the reader, we do have a responsibility to protect ourselves, to read the other person's comment first. So I always try and think maybe that person's having a bad day and not take it too personally, and then just remember that we all parent differently. And then when I talk about that, like I did the other day on my page, a whole lot of other people came out and said, we feel the same. We just do our own thing and we don't want to be told what to do.
You have to develop a little bit of a thick skin
too.
You do
have to develop a bit of a thick skin. And when you've got 50,000 followers, you do get more and more and more of that criticism and that judgment. But it comes with the game, so it comes with the territory.
Hey, well, it's been a pleasure too. And you really are putting yourself out there with your blog. And those videos are just hilarious. You should definitely go and watch them. Thank you so much for joining us on the show, Maria.
Thank you for having me.
And if you're not one of Happy Mum, Happy Child's 50,000, actually over 50,000 Facebook followers, then make sure that you go and check her out.